الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الكريم خاتم النبيين ورحمة للعالمين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي اللهم اجعلنا دعاة إليك وإلى رسولك أما بعد فقد قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنا عند ظن عبدي أنا عند ظن عبدي بي وانا معه اذا ذكرني الى الاخر الحديث صدق الله العلي العظيم وصدق رسول الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين ومن الشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين Indeed all praises are for Allah. Allah is one. Allah is al-ahad. Allah is eternal and absolute. Allah is as-samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Allah begets not, nor is He begotten. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ There is nothing and there is no one to compare to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator, al-khaliq, of the heavens and the earth, وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا And whatever is between them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-raziq. Allah is the sustainer. Allah sustains all the creatures in the heavens, in the earth, in the oceans, wherever they might be found. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-ghani. Allah is so rich that His treasures does not diminish in the least. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that one who gives and forgives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Nabi Kareem, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Khatimun Nabiyyin, as the last of the Prophet, the seal of the Prophets, as Rahmatul Alameen, a mercy to the entire world. We send peace and blessings upon him. Wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. My dear brothers, my dear sisters, the month of Dhul-Qadah is going away. The month of Dhul-Qadah, this blessed month of Allah, it's passing and it's going away very quickly. Very soon we will be looking for the new moon, inshallah, on Sunday night or Monday night to begin the month of Dhul-Hijjah, the last month in the Islamic calendar, which is also a very sacred month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just as He has made many things blessed, just as He has made a lot of significance in His creation, there is something that Allah has made very special for the humankind as well. It is something which is known as time. Time, Allah makes an entire surah, or Allah has revealed an entire surah called Surat al-Asr. It is known as time. Time is very precious. It is very valuable. It is very unique. It is like a block of ice that keeps melting away. If we don't make proper use of our time, what are we going to say to Allah when we stand on the day of Qiyamah? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created time, we understand it as human beings by days, by weeks, by months, by years. This time that Allah has created with days and nights, Allah has made some nights very special. The last 10 nights in the month of Ramadan, we know it for its importance. We know the value of those nights. But from those 10 nights, Allah has chosen out one night which is greater in merits than 1,000 months. These 10 days which are coming up, the first 10 days in the month of Dhul-Hijjah, the first 10 days, Allah has made them very special too. But there is one day which is known as the day of Arafah. Anybody who is performing Hajj and they misses that day of Arafah, then they did not have Hajj at all. So important. In the week that Allah has created, 7 days in a week, Allah has made one day very special in that week. It is known as Yawmul Jum'ah. So this time that Allah has given to us, Allah has made exception for certain days and certain nights that He holds in high esteem. This month of Hajj, Dhul-Hijjah, it is one of those months that Hajj cannot be performed in any other month except for this. The month of Ramadan, fasting, fawd fasting, fasting which has been made compulsory upon us, it cannot be performed in any other month except in the month of Ramadan. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has designed the book of Allah, which is known as the Quran, the way of life, which is known as Islam, for you and I who call ourselves Muslimin and Muslimat. When we look at all the gifts that Allah has given to mankind, so many different things. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the greatest gifts that Allah has given to us. Islam, a beautiful gift that that Allah has given to us. The Quran, a beautiful gift that Allah has given to us. The title of being called a Muslim, this is a gift from Allah. What is the greatest gift of all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us is something which is known as life itself. Allah has given us life as one of the greatest gifts ever. What is our gift back to Allah? What is our gift back to Allah? Is what we make out of this life that Allah has given to us. How do I spend my days and my nights? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's a very famous hadith and we hear it all the time. اغتنم خمسا قبل الخمس, make use of 5 things before 5 other things overtake these 5. شبابك قبل حرمك, make use of your youth before old age comes. Because youth in itself is one of the greatest gifts that Allah has given. Youth, we know what it feels like to be a youth. We know what it feels like, some of us, to be old. To be called an old man or an old woman. Our bones are weak. We are so tired. We become helpless. But the youth, subhanAllah, he's always on the go. Make use of your youth before old age comes. Make use of your health before sickness comes. Make use of your wealth before poverty comes. Make use of your free time before you become busy. And last but not least, make use of your life before death comes. Make use of your life before death comes, because this is our gift that we will be given back to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants us. He wants us to think about Him all the time. He wants us to remember Him. He wants us to connect to Him. Just last week we were speaking about the hearts connecting to Allah, making the love of Allah the first and foremost thing in our hearts and into our lives. From last week to this week, if I were to ask you, how much closer have we gotten to Allah, or how farther away have we gone from Allah? From last week to this week, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever would have listened attentively to the khutbah last week, from that time until today, Allah would have washed away all his minor sins for him. How much closer have we drawn to Allah? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about a hadith Qudsi. A hadith Qudsi is that hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has narrated. He said it. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he explained it in his own words. Allah says, He says, "Ana inda dhanni 'abdi bi." I am as my servants think about me. How much you think that Allah can help you, that's the amount that Allah will help you. How much you think that Allah is able to give you, that is the amount Allah is going to give you. Whatever it is you think about Allah, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is the extent of Allah's power? Allah is going to give that to you. Allah is saying, I am as my servant thinks about me. وَأَنَا مَعَهُ إِذَا ذَكَرَنِي And I am with him when he remembers me. What is Allah saying here in this hadith Qudsi? Understand it very well, you know. I am with him when he remembers me. If we look at the opposite to that, let's contrast that statement. If he does not remember me, where will I be? I am with that servant of mine when he remembers me. If he remembers me in a gathering, in a majlis, in an assembly with a lot of people, and we know how hard that is today, when we go anywhere and we sit in gatherings, we sit with our friends, we sit with our families, we go out in society, the last thing that comes on our minds sometimes is Allah. We talk about everything, we talk about everybody, and the last thing in our minds is Allah. Sometimes, when you fall in love with somebody, this happens a lot. When a man falls in love with a woman, wherever that man will go, this man, his parents have already talked to that, the woman, the girl's parents, in order for both of them to get married. So his thoughts is only about this woman he's going to get married to. Wherever this man might go, he can be in the largest gathering, the biggest of crowds. He doesn't see anybody there. His mind and his heart is on who? That woman that he is going to get married to. He does not observe anything. Allah is saying, if you people were to remember me in such a crowd, in such a gathering, then I, Allah, I am going to remember you in such a gathering that is better than where you remembered me. Subhanallah. What gathering is that? The gathering of the malaika, of the angels. These angels who have never sinned. Just last week we spoke about them. How they have been standing since they have been created. Some of them in sijda since they have been created. When they will raise their heads. When they will look at Allah. They will say, oh Allah, we did not praise you as we ought to praise you. Your name is being mentioned in that assembly. How many angels are there? Listen to it. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the night of Mi'raj, when he was made to ascend the heavens and he reached to the seven heavens on Baytul Ma'amur, on that house which is in heaven, leaning on that house was Ibrahim alayhi salam, the Kaaba of the heavens. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says 70,000 angels, they make tawaf around that house and they will never ever see it again. 70,000 make tawaf. From the moment they finish their tawaf, another 70 comes. A new 70 comes. And they will never see it again until the day of Qiyamah. Imagine that assembly with Allah. When we remember Allah with 50, 60, 100 people, where is our name being remembered? Where is Allah? Where is our name being mentioned with Allah? With the assemblies of angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues in this hadith. He says, if you were to come to me, if you were to come to me by a hand span, I am going to come to you an arm's length. An arm's length. What does that mean? Does it mean that we measure a hand span and an arm's length? No. It doesn't mean that. How far you were, measure your time and see how near you are to Allah now. How near, how much closer have you drawn to Allah now? It's a matter of time we are speaking about, not just length of the hand, no. If you were a hand span away from Allah, and now you have drawn a hand span closer to Allah, Allah will come an arm's length, the length of that time. That is how Allah is speaking here. Subhanallah. If you go walking to Allah, Allah comes running to you. Not that Allah will run to you. No. Allah comes to you so fast. Faster than the twinkling of your eyes. Allah comes and Allah establishes his place in your heart. That you can't forget Allah now. Everywhere you go, you see Allah's manifestation. Everywhere you go, you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout his makhlukat and his creation. So this is the life. Allah has given us this life as a big gift from him. And what we are giving back to Allah as our gift is what we make out of this life. Look at how it happens. When a child comes on the face of the earth, this child, he enters the world. And as this child grows, this child understands who his mother is. There is a connection. The child knows the mother's name. The child grows and grows, and the child becomes a person in society. That child gets married. The child goes out from the mother's house. Time and again, the child will pick up the phone. He will call his mom. He will pick up the phone. He will visit his mother. He will take a gift to his mother. There is a connection between the child and the mother. But this said child, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, the child does not think for once that the same way he has this connection with that woman who carried him for 9 months in her belly, the same connection that he has, the same way he will pick up the phone and he will call the mom because he misses the mom, this same child refuses to take his head and put in the ground 5 times a day. To remember the one who took care of him in his mother's belly. To remember the one who took care of his mother who was taking care of him. This child does not find time to send a gift to his creator by prostrating 5 times a day. This child does not find time to pick up the phone and speak to his creator by opening the book of Allah, which is the direct words of Allah. This child does not find no time for this Allah who has taken care of him, but this child is connected to his mother so much. Where is the connection really supposed to be? With the maker, the creator, not the created. Because we would leave, we will separate, we will disconnect from everybody here. But if we disconnect with Allah, then my dear brothers and my dear sisters, sad to say, we will be lost on the day of Qiyamah. What is Allah telling us in the glorious Quran? Allah is saying that a time will come when we will stand before Allah, and because of our forgetfulness, of that we have to go back to Him, that we have to meet with Him, some words will be mentioned to us on that day. فَذُوقُوا بِمَا نَسِيتُمْ لِقَاءَ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا. Allah will say to us, taste of this blazing fire because you fail to remember the meeting of your Lord. This day, you did not think about it. You did not even fathom that one day you're going to stand before Allah. You are going to meet with Allah because you forgot about that. How can a person forget that he's going to meet Allah? It's because he has forgotten Allah. Because you have forgotten that, Allah is saying, Fadhuku, taste this fire of Jahannam. Inna nasinakum. Allah is saying, we also have forgotten you. Allah have also forgotten you. And this is why you are being made to taste this fire on the day of Qiyamah, because of forgetfulness. On the contrary, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Allah is saying, if you remember me, I am going to remember you. وَشْكُرُولِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. Be grateful to me. Don't ever show ingratitude. Don't ever show ingratitude. All the symbols of Hajj, all the symbols of Hajj for all those people who are going, everything around Makkah and Medina, everything around the precincts of the Kaaba, it is a symbol and it is a sign for those people to bring back Allah into their remembrance. Everything we see, it is to remember Allah. From the moment we see the Kaaba, it is to remember Allah. To make tawaf, it's to remember Allah. Everything is surrounded in the zikr of Allah. Every single thing. Our lives is surrounded by the zikr of Allah. And this is what we make out of our lives. This is the ibadah that Allah wants when He created man and He says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. That I have not created the jinns and the man except that they will worship me. Yani, in other words, except that they will bring my name into the remembrance all the time. This is the ibadah of Allah. This is the worship of Allah. It is not only to perform salah 5 times a day, but every other act of ibadah. When we wake up, before we sleep, when we use the washroom, with our wives, with our children, whatever it might be, in business transaction, it has to have the remembrance of Allah in that. And this, my dear brothers and sisters, sad to say, It has left the hearts of many people. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us about a man. He says, يَعْجُبُ رَبُّكَ مِنْ رَائِي غَنَمٍ. He says, your Lord delights at a man, a shepherd. It's so amazing. Your Lord is amazed. He is surprised. He becomes happy at this shepherd. He stands at the mountain peak, so high up at the mountain tops, steep, rough rocks. He is standing at the peak of that mountain. Subhanallah, yu'adhinu bis-salah. He calls out the adhan for salah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. After he calls out the adhan, he is alone. Where is he? At the top of the mountains. After he calls out the adhan, wa yusalli, he performs the salah. He prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fayaqulu Allahu azza wa jal. Allah says now, Allah the Almighty, Allah the Exalted, he says, unzuru ila abdi hadha. Oh my angels, ya ayyuha nas, oh mankind dwelling on the earth, look at this servant of mine. You look at this servant of mine. Subhanallah. What is there about this servant of mine? Yu'adhinu wa yuqimu salah. He calls out the adhan. He calls out the call for prayer. And not only did he call it out and he went about his business, he calls it out and he established the prayer. He performed the prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ya khafu minni. He did that because he is afraid of me, because of awe for me, because of my anger, because of my ghadab. He did this out of fear for me. Allah says to that servant, قَدْ غَفَرْتُ لِعَبَدِي. I have forgiven this servant of mine. I have forgiven this servant of mine. Not only that, وَأَدْخَلْتُهُ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. And I have admitted him in Jannah. One man, alone, on the mountaintops, he remembers his Lord. He remembers his Creator. You know they say when you're alone, what happens? Shaitan snatches the lone sheep. Shaitan takes you. But this man, because of love in his heart for his Allah, because he know that his gift to Allah is what deeds he do to please Allah. This fear in his heart for Allah, he calls out the prayer. He performs the prayer. Allah is saying, I have forgiven him. And I have admitted him in Jannah. Where was he when Allah made that statement? He was still on the land. He was still on the land. And this hadith, my dear brothers and sisters, it is not only specific for this one individual. This hadith is for every servant like him. Every servant of Allah who is like this individual, wherever we are, when the time for salah comes, the consciousness of this Allah, it enters the heart. And we perform salah wherever we are. We remember Allah wherever we are. This is the object. This is the objective in our lives. To bring this Allah into our hearts. To bring this Allah into our lives. To become connected to this Allah. When we fail to remember this Allah, then this Allah is also going to forget us. When Allah forgets us, then what becomes of us? We just become like living deads, as the hadith says. مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرُ رَبَّهُ وَالَّذِي لَا يَذْكُرُ كَمَثَلِ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ. The similitude, the example of that one who will remember his Allah, that one who Allah will be in his heart all the time, that one who will be conscious of his Allah is just like the, and the one who does not remember his Allah, the example of these two people, the one who remembers and the one who does not remember, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, is just like the example of the living and the dead. And this is why people say, but you're like a living dead on earth. In other words, you're a waste of time. Because you're living and you fail to remember the one who gave you life. This precious gift. How could that be? We don't forget our moms. As a matter of fact, some of us do. We remember on Mother's Day. But greater than our mothers and our fathers is Allah. Greater than any king is Allah. Greater than any ruler is Allah. Greater than any administrator is Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who has to be in our hearts all the time. Look at us. Look at our creation. Look at how beautiful we are. Some of us, we stand in front of the mirror and we admire ourselves. Who is this one who has created us in this fashion? Alladhi ahsana, alladhi ahsana kulla shayin khalaqahu wa bada'a khalqal insana min teen. This Allah is that one who has created everything. Ahsana, in excellence. Not just good, not just nice. In excellence Allah has created every single thing. Allah uses the highest form of the word, hasana. And Allah uses ahsan, greater than beautiful, greater than nice. Allah is saying what? To the most perfect. Allah has created everything in the most perfect way. وَبَدَأَ خَلْقَ الْإِنسَانِ مِنْ تِينٍ. And Allah has begun the creation of man from clay, from mud. ثُمَّ جَعَلَ نَسْلَهُ مِنْ سُلَالَةٍ مِنْ مَاءٍ مَهِينٍ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has made the progeny of man, the offspring of man, from this despicable fluid, from this despised water. The water, when it touches you, you want to get rid of it. You want to wash it away. You want to wipe it away. The semen, Allah has created man from that. Then Allah says, ثُمَّ سَوَّاهُ وَنَفَقَ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِهِ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He fashioned man. He blew into man from his spirit. He blew that air of life into man because man is lying. Adam alayhi salam was created and he was lying there until Allah blew the breath of life in him. This is what has us going. Then, وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمَعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ. Then Allah gave us, He gave us sight, He gave us hearing, He gave us hearts. But what Allah is completing that sentence with? قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ. But very little thanks do you give. Very little thanks do you give for this perfect creation, this perfect way that Allah has created us. We give little thanks to Allah. The gift of Allah. The gift that we have to give back to Allah. Again, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, is what use we make out of this life. Not by saying, you know, I went and fete and party, you know, I make real good use of my life. No, it's not that. When we have to answer the first thing on the day of Qiyamah, how did you spend your youths? How did you spend your youths? What are we going to say to Allah? The gift that we have to give back to Allah is what use we made of this life in the manner in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had prescribed for us. That is what we call making use of your life. The way that Allah had prescribed it for you. This is what we call making use of our lives. So my dear brothers and my dear sisters, we all have an opportunity. We all have a chance. And every single day Allah gives us more and more to do something good with our lives. Allah gives us so many different chances to make use of this life, this gift that He has given to us. If we fail to make use of this gift, one day, we're going to close our eyes. One day, Allah is going to take it away. And when Allah takes it away, we will be saying, Oh Allah, send me back. Oh Allah, send me back. Now, I will do the things that you had asked me to do. But then what will happen? It will be too late. It will be too late. Sometimes we see us as Muslims. Just recently, we had a big election. A big election. This ummah, Allah says, we are ummatun wahida. This is one ummah. One ummah, one ummah. Understand that term, one. It's not half, it's not divided. Allah commands us, wala tafarraqu. Do not be divided amongst yourselves. No matter what. Sometimes we find so much quarrels. Why? This fellow would vote for ILP, this one vote for PNM, that one vote for UNC. And everybody calling. And then people in parliament drinking coffee and shaking hands. Eh? And we fighting amongst ourselves. For what? This one vote for that one vote for that one. My party win, your party lost. Eh? Fighting and quarreling over nothing. Over nothing. We are one ummah. We have to be united on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. This is good for us. And we have to be united on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. This is bad for us. We have to be united on those things. This is not a meeting. This is a weeting. It's a weeting. This deen is not mine. It's ours. What Allah says is good for me, it's good for all of us. What Allah says is good for you, it's good for all of us. What Allah says is bad for me, it's bad for all of us. This is the deen of Allah. It can't be good for one and bad for the other one. No. This is not how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala operates. So here we are in the month of Dhul-Qa'dah. Just like the clock is ticking away, our heartbeats are also ticking away. Every single beat is a beat less. Let us understand that just as this year is coming to an end, so too our lives, they are coming to an end. And if we don't have this gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us, we don't have any good things in this to present to Allah, then on the day of Qiyamah, sad to say, we will be tasting from that fire, the fire of hell that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. And my dear brothers and my dear sisters, really and truly, we don't want a taste of that. We don't want a taste of that. We see of some people, when they die, we see that a stick of fire is placed in their mouths, right here on the earth, you know. Right here on the earth. Yeah. Some people, they get rid of their disease like that. We as Muslims, we bury. We bury. Because why? Minha khalaqnakum. Because from the earth, Allah says, we create you. Wa fiha nu'idukum. And into the earth, we return you. Wa minha nukhrijukum taratan ukhra. And from that very earth, we're going to bring you back once again. We're going to bring you back. So when Allah says, tasting the fire, we could well imagine how people taste it right here. We could well imagine it's really going to be placed in the mouths of those people who has forgotten Allah. So may we not be from amongst those people. May we bring Allah's remembrance into our lives, into our hearts. May we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this makhlukat, in this creation. Allah is existing throughout. When we look at our face, we should see Allah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this. Look at where the nose is, where the ears is, where the eyes is. So perfect. This is how our creator has created us. Perfect. When we look at the butterfly, subhanallah, we look at the moths, we look at every single thing, the caterpillar, we look at the honeybees, we look at the ants, these small insignificant things, as we will say, Allah has given them a price. They are gems of Allah. Allah mentions them in the Quran. The little thing as the spider, subhanallah. The ants is mentioned in the Quran. The bee is mentioned in the Quran. Allah gives importance to them. Allah gives importance to them. So much importance that Allah has given to them. Allah has given most importance to mankind. To mankind. Subhanallah. Allah addresses us. Ya ayyuhal insan. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Subhanallah. No other creation Allah has given this mankind. Allah has given us aql, Allah has given us intelligence. Let us use it. Let us use it to do those things so that we will benefit our souls, we will benefit our lives. And when we stand before Allah on the day of Qiyamah, we will see all the gifts that Allah had given to us, the gift of life, the gift of deen, the gift of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We will now see this on the day of Qiyamah, how obedient we were to Allah in this life. How obedient we were to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this life. How much did I pay heed to what Allah spoke to me about in the Quran? How much did I practice as a believer? Everything, we will see it presented to us on the day of Qiyamah. And mind you, when that book is open in front of us, when that book is open in front of us, some of us, we would look at that book and we will begin to hold our heads and bawl. We will begin to hold our heads and bawl. We will question, what is wrong with this book? Mali hadal kitab. What is wrong with this book? This book has not left out any big thing or any small thing. Everything is contained in this book. The minutest is contained in this book. We will say, boy, what's wrong with this book, boy? Everything in that book? Everything. So my dear brothers and sisters, if we want to get our book of deeds in our right hands, in front of us, with faces beaming, bright and shiny, then we have to make use of this life and send back the gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed for us all. Wal akhir da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.